You'd be pretty stupid to carry on this smuggling racket with a department spy in the prison, wouldn't you? That is, of course, unless she happens to be on your side.
I think you've just earned yourself a charge.
Oh, yeah? What are you going to tell Davo? That I gave you cheek about Maxie's fence drop this arvo?
Fence drop? What are you talking about?
You are rostered on duty in H Block, so you stay there until you're relieved.
Yes, I know that, but I'm looking for contraband. My information is that there's to be a smuggling drop over the fence this afternoon.
What surprises me more than anything else is that you believe Smith.
I didn't, but we can't take any chances, can we?
Daniels follows her around like a shadow, so why would Smith lag on her?
Depends what's being smuggled in. Now, we all know how Smith feels about drugs.
All right, I suppose it's possible. Let's go and question Daniels and see what we can find out.
Well, just don't overdo it tomorrow, Lizzie. You leave the heavy work to us.
Oh, God, anyone would think I had one bloody foot in the grave. I don't want to stay in the kitchen all the time. Would it be all right with you if I left sometimes, Miss Daniels?
I will think about it, Mrs. Birdsworth.
By jabbum. I just want to meet some different people, that's all.
Thanks very much.
Well, you know what I mean.
Yeah, well, we could have scored better than what we have. Some of those girls that live with Judah are a bit off. But between that Lindy and Mrs. Collins, I'll never get to know Trevor.
Well, you said he was a bit backward and coming forward yourself, didn't you?
Well, who wouldn't be with a mother like that? Look, I just want to be friends, and I haven't given up yet.
Outside, Daniels.
Who, me?
Did I mention anyone else?
Come on, Daniels, move it.
God, I wonder what's happening.
I don't know. It looks like they meant business, though.
You didn't open your mouth about the grog, did you?
Of course not. Anyway, that was days ago. The screws wouldn't have waited around till now to do something about it, would they?
Why not? They don't think too quick. Bugger the grog. It's Maxie. She's really gonna cop it. Well, we'll just have to wait and find out. And if anybody else gets dragged out, keep your mouths shut. And Maxine had better be doing the same.
Don't waste my time, Daniels. Now, we know that you've been having goods smuggled in from the outside, and we would like the details.
What goods? What are you talking about?
Don't play dumb with us, Daniels.
Well, I don't know who or where you got your information from, but it's wrong.
Really? Well, perhaps you won't find it so easy to lie when we confiscate your latest shipment.
What?
Take her back to the others for now. I'll organize a thorough search of the perimeter fence.
Right.
What the bloody hell are you both on about?
Don't, Daniels. I warned you about organizing anything while Clark's in here.
Well, I'm not. What's Po-Face organizing a search now for? She's a bit late, isn't she?
Not from what I've heard.
Oh, yeah, which is what?
That you're expecting a drop over the fence this afternoon.
Yeah? Well, it's news to me. Who put you onto that?
Your good mate, Smith.
B?
That's right. She told me herself. She's not too happy about our little arrangement, is she?
B wouldn't lag. Anyway, I don't know what's going on. I certainly don't know nothing about a load of goods coming over the fence.
You'd better not, Daniels, because if I find out that you do, you and I are going to have another little chat.
You busy?
No, I'm just having a break. What's wrong?
We've just had word that Daniels is expecting a drop of goods over the fence this afternoon. I want the perimeter fence searched. Would you get O'Shea and Barfield to meet me outside?
Of course. Where did you get this information?
Smith.
Don't get too settled, Daniels. We'll be calling on you later.
What you do, Maxie?
They think I've been getting goods smuggled in from the outside.
We don't think, Daniels. We know. And we're going to put a stop to it.
Who's she putting on a show for? Super spy. Who else? God, I don't know what to believe anymore.
Why aren't the screws get on to you, love?
The freak reckons B lagged.
Ah, B wouldn't lag.
You don't believe it, do you?
I don't know. She was really against the trading and the insurance. Maybe she just had enough. She wouldn't lag. Yeah, well, maybe she's just having a joke on the screws.
Some joke when you put a mate in at the same time.
Well, whatever she did it for, she must have had a bloody good reason.
Maybe it was just a diversion so she could get over the wall.
Yeah, but I'm just not going to leave it at that. I'll see her at dinner time and find out why she did it.
Found anything?
No, not a thing.
Still can't believe B would have lagged on Maxine. Must be a joke or something.
Yeah, well, of course that's possible, but Daniel seemed genuine enough. I'll talk to Smith.
She's on kitchen duty.
Is she? I was in there just before the break and she wasn't there.
Well, that's where she's supposed to be.
I don't like the sound of this.
Neither do I. We'd better find her quick.
An immediate head count. Come on.
Everybody's accounted for everywhere else.
Well, we've definitely got one missing here. No prizes for guessing who it is.
Lock them up. I'll inform the governor.
All right, ladies. Back to your dormitories.
Maybe I was right after all, Birdbrain. Looks like your little playmate's gone and left you.
Shut your bloody big mouth, Mackenzie. What's going on, Mrs. Sam?
No questions, Lizzie. Back into your cell.
Oh, God. First they take me out of the laundry. Now they're putting us in our cell.
That's enough, Daniels.
Oh, be where are you, love?
All the women are in their cells.
Did any of them say anything?
No, they didn't. They seem just as curious as we are.
Well, we organised a thorough search of the building. I don't want anyone panicking at this stage.
It's my bet she is still in the building, waiting until tonight.
Why do you say that?
There have been no delivery vans in or out. No sign of a break through the fence.
Well, let's hope you're right. It's an interesting time for the trainees to be doing their practical, isn't it?
The trainees? Now, she might have slipped out with them.
Oh, she would have needed a uniform. Where would she get it from?
The staff room. She was on kitchen duty, and some of us would have had spare uniforms in our lockers. I know I did.
Would you check that, please, Miss Ferguson? I'll speak to the gate guard straight away.
Hey, now, come on, Lizzie. You said that Bea always reckoned there was no point in escaping. I've even heard her say it myself.
But where is she, love?
Oh, I don't know. She'll show up.
I reckon Mackenzie's right. She's gone, Maxie.
But how? And why would she change her mind?
Well, you just think about it. You just think about the last few months. Ever since that bloody Ferguson turned up, she fought for us over her. She even stuffed up her own parole. And what did we do in return? Nothing. Every time the freak waved a few fags or a bit of grog in our faces, we fell for it. We must have been through hell.
But she's still top dog around here, Lizzie.
Well, what's the point of that if she hasn't got our support? She told us we could look after ourselves from now on. And if she's gone, and I reckon she might have. I don't blame her one little bit. Because it's all our fault, Maxie. We pushed her out.
Didn't you check how many in the group as they left?
Well, no.
But surely you checked how many passes had been handed in.
Normally I do, but...
Good. God, what do you do all day?
I'm sorry, Mrs. Davison, but Frank Moore's been bringing groups in here for years. We know each other well. I didn't think to question how many he had in his group.
All right, you'd better get back to the gate.
Thanks.
And from now on, check everybody who comes in and out of those gates.
Yes, I will.
I found this in one of the bins.
Hair colour?
And there is a uniform missing. Joan Ferguson's.
Oh. Well, obviously Smith is gone. You better call the police, tell them how well she's disguised. I'll phone the department and then I'll question the women.
You know, the only thing I don't like about this is that Nola's right. They must use that story about me as a diversion to get away.
Of course she did. Bea wouldn't lag on a mate. And the freak would have fallen for it because she would have been worried that you and Nola would try to put one over her.
Yeah.
I wonder how she set it up.
Attention, everybody. The governor wants to speak to you.
Listen, let's see what's going on.
As you are probably aware, Bea Smith is missing. We suspect she has escaped. Now, if any of you know anything, I expect your full cooperation. If she is on the run, she is in great danger. The police have been alerted and will be on the lookout for her.
Oh, good. They'll shoot first and they'll ask questions later. Mrs. Davidson, can I talk to you, please?
Unlock Birdsworth's cell, please, Miss Ferguson. Well, Lizzie, do you know where B is?
No, Mrs. Davidson, I wish I did. None of us know anything. If she was going to tell anyone, she would have told me.
Well, that's right, Mrs. Davidson.
Yes. Yes, I believe you are telling the truth, Lizzie. Thank you.
Oh, Mrs. Davidson, please tell the cops she's not dangerous. Bea. Take care of yourself, love.
Well, it seems we're looking for a very clever lady. Although her escape couldn't have been any easier if it were handed to her on a plate.
That is not the case at all, Sergeant.
The facts, Mrs. Davidson, are that Smith waltzed out of here this afternoon, hair dyed with some product I believe can't be obtained from the buyer, and in complete officer's uniform belonging to you, Miss...
Ferguson.
Ferguson. She also managed to trick, I believe it was you again, Miss Ferguson, into leaving your post so that she could join the crowd of trainee officers that were here today.
Miss Ferguson had good reason to follow up the information she received.
From Smith?
That's correct.
You believe that a so-called top dog would lag on one of her mates?
Smith's attitude to drugs is well known in this prison. I assume that that's what would be coming over the fence.
Well, does Daniels have any record for pushing drugs?
No, she doesn't, but I don't see that proves anything. Boredom is the greatest evil in this place, Sergeant, and if the women feel that drugs will help ease that boredom, then they'll try to get them. Daniels was questioned, and Mrs. Powell was of the impression that the prisoner was in fact guilty.
But your officers found nothing in the grounds?
No, nothing.
And you questioned the women yourself about this escape, Mrs. Davidson?
Yes. Birdsworth is very close to Smith, and she claims that the women didn't help Smith whatsoever. I'm inclined to believe her.
Oh, so am I. I'd say Miss Ferguson gave her all the help she needed.
I resent that implication. There is no evidence
that
to suggest...
enough, Miss Ferguson. Sergeant, what steps have you taken to recapture Smith?
Normal procedures, plus a full description of Smith has been circulated to the media and will be publicised as soon as possible.
I would prefer the papers did not receive details of the full escape.
No, that's got nothing to do with me. We'll be getting an official statement from the department. It'll be up to them. Well, thank you for your time, ladies.
I'll see them out, Miss Ferguson.
I have to speak to the union about this. Nearly 5 hours without a break.
I don't think Smith took that into account when she left.
I'm worried, Colleen. What if Bea resists arrest? I mean, the police know she's in for double murder. You know what that could mean, don't you?
I am more concerned about what the press will do to us when they find out.
That won't be pleasant. I bet Ted Douglas is reaching for his heart pills right now. All the same, I can't help feeling glad that Jones finally slipped up, and by falling for one of Bea's tricks. I hope Douglas thinks twice about her efficiency now.
I'll be at home if I'm needed. Otherwise, I'll see you in the morning.
Bye.
Yes, Mick, she did hear that.
She knows what I think of her. She also knows I'm right about what the department will have to say.
Listen, I'm not sure that Daniels is so innocent. I think it's worth having a talk to her.
All right, I'll come with you.
Do you know exactly how Smith got out?
No comment.
Is it true she literally walked through these gates? Who was on duty at the time?
I'm sorry, I can't give you any details. You'll have to wait for the official statement from the department.
I believe Smith's quite an important figure in the prison. The women know her as their top dog, is that right? Well, is this the same B. Smith who wrote articles for the Dispatch some months back?
Look, I've told you I can't answer your questions. Now, you're all blocking the main entrance here, so would you please clear the driveway?
That'll do, Max. Not going to get anything out of him. Start rolling again. Here comes one of the officers. Excuse me. Have you been on duty all day? Can you tell us anything about B. Smith's escape?
No, I can't.
Well, what's the department's feeling on what's happened?
No comment.
Well, it seems Smith had no trouble in getting out this afternoon. Yeah, she's well disguised from the description we've been given.
Look, I have had the misfortune of seeing you on television, and I'm not interested in your sensational garbage. Now leave me alone.
I think we'll edit that out, Max. Set up for a general report. Cut in some of the footage you got on the gate guard. We might be able to use some of what she said, but I doubt it.
Mrs. Davidson believed us when we said we didn't know nothing.
I am not Mrs. Davidson.
That's for sure.
Don't! I'm not in the mood.
Well, I can't tell you what I don't know, can I?
Smith seems to think you knew plenty.
Oh, God, here we go again. That was a diversion. Why would B lag on one of her mates?
Drugs.
Oh, come off it. I've never been into anything like that. Check me record.
Well, there's always a first time. And we know how Smith feels about drugs.
Well, that's exactly why I wouldn't have nothing to do with the rotten stuff. B would kill me, and I know it.
How long has she had this escape planned?
I don't know.
Where would she go? Has she talked to anyone on the outside lately?
She hasn't got anyone on the outside, remember?
Think, Maxine, she must have said something.
Look, what do I have to say to convince you? I don't know nothing about B's escape. Nobody does. Look, what's wrong here?
All right, that's it. You're on a charge.
Oh, come off it, Mrs. Powell. Look,
you can forget any phone calls for a week, incoming or outgoing.
Oh, but that's not fair.
Don't push your luck, Daniels. Wait outside.
Hard on her, weren't you?
We have to find out as much as we can, as soon as we can. Otherwise, we're going to have them all wandering around, doped out of their minds.
Now, do you really think she knows anything about any drugs or B's escape?
Well, Smith had to have some help. And who better than some silly little cellmate that worships her? Take her back the others, will you?
Right.
Come on, Lizzie. Oh, stop pushing me. I'm trying to sort out what sort of cards to keep.
I've been doing that for 5 minutes. Come on.
If you don't want me to play, just say something.
Oh, you've ruined the whole game now.
Great. It's getting on my nerves anyway.
What's wrong, Lizzie?
You ask me what's wrong with B out there and a lot of trigger-happy cops after her.
She can look after herself.
Yeah, well, she's been doing that a bit too long, hasn't she? And there's not any of us here have done anything to help her.
Oh, come on, Lizzie. She had lots of mates in here.
You call them mates. I call a mate at standby, you know, no matter what. She's been doing that for me for years, and she's been doing it for most of us too.
You're the ones who made her top dog. It's her job. But she hasn't been doing it too well lately.
Well, she was up until yesterday. And after what we've done, I don't suppose she could see there was any point in it anymore.
What do you mean, Lizzie?
What do I mean? She's been running around after us all these years while we've been sucking up to bent screws and money-hungry bloody prisoners.
But that wouldn't be enough to make her go over the wall.
Of course it would. Who'd want to hang around looking after a lot of backstabbers like us?
Okay, so what? You don't need around all the time telling you what to do. Face the facts. She can't deliver the goods. I can. She gets the sults and goes over the wall. You're still stuck in here, and I've still got the merchandise. So, who needs her?
Does that mean you're still going to keep up the trading and insurance, Nola?
I warned you about asking too many questions, Clark.
Oh, heard anything about B, Mrs. M?
No, nothing.
You better start packing up. You'll be going back to your cell shortly.
Oh, can't we watch the late night news?
No, lights out at the usual time.
What they want you for this time, Nath?
Oh, Pearl wouldn't believe me that we didn't know nothing about Bee's escape. And get this, she reckons I'm pushing drugs.
Oh. Drugs?
Yes. She really went off. Anyway, I lost me cool and copped a charge. Hey, Nola, you gonna pay up? I lost phone privileges for a week.
Yeah. Let's see you deliver the merchandise now.
All right. I'll get it.
Ben had dropped me in like that. I mean, fair enough, she had to do something, but now the screws are going to be watching me like hawks. Oh, why did she have to dob in one of her mates?
If you're talking about Smith, that's not the only thing she's done.
Oh, what are you on about? Where's me money?
It's not there.
What?
I searched and it's not there. Smith's taken off with all your insurance money.
Oh, why do you think that it had to be her?
All right, we'll find out. Anybody else take it? Anybody else silly enough to think they can hide that much dough from me?
I don't even know where you had it stashed.
None of us did.
Then how did Bee find out?
I don't know, but she did somehow.
Oh, I don't believe it. But if she has, good luck to her.
Well, I don't care what's happened. I'm still claiming.
How can I pay if I've been cleaned out?
Speak to the freak. She's your partner. She should be able to scrape together a few dollars after the cut she's been taken.
I can't ask her.
You're gonna have to.
The freak? You mean Ferguson's been the one that's been helping you get the stuff in?
You're a bloody smart bugger, aren't you?
Well, I just thought...
Well, you can stop thinking and you can stop asking, because no one's gonna tell you anything you want to know. You're a department spy and we all know it, so you can just shut up.
Mrs. Powell, is the governor still here?
Yes, why?
I have to see her.
Reason?
I'm sorry, but it's private.
Is it about the escape?
Yes.
Why haven't you come forward with this information before?
Well, I didn't know anything before. I've just heard the women talking.
And now you're going to tell the governor everything the others have said?
Isn't that what you want?
Oh, but Clark, that's lagging. Haven't the women told you what happens to laggers in here?
Please, Mrs. Powell, it's important.
Yes, well, I suppose it is time you reported in. The department wouldn't have heard from you for a few days, would they?
I see. Let's stop playing games and go to the governor's office, shall we?
Hmm. Come with me. Jill Clark wants to see you.
Let's send her in, please.
Miss Clark?
Mrs. Davidson, the women know I'm from the department. So do the other officers, it seems.
Have you any idea how the women found out, Mrs. Powell?
No, but I'll check it out.
I can't stay here now. Apart from being dangerous, there's no point, is there?
Well, it's too late to contact Mr. Douglas. I'll authorise your release. Would you get the file for me, please, Mrs. Powell? I can't say I'm sorry this exercise is over. I told Mr. Douglas the women would find out about you sooner or later.
Yes, but I'd like to know how. And I'm sure Mr. Douglas would too.
Morning. Seen the papers?
Of course I have.
Well, they've made us out to look incredibly stupid. The department isn't going to be happy with any of this.
Have you got a minute, Miss Ferguson? We've got a problem.
What is it, Mackenzie?
A certain roll of insurance money that I had hidden in a safe place has gone missing.
That's your problem, Mackenzie, not mine.
Well, who could have got at it?
Not me, if that's what you're trying to pull. How much has gone?
Oh, about 2,500. Can you think of anybody who'd want that sort of money?
Only someone who was planning an escape?
Exactly. Smith could get quite a long way with that amount. It'd be nice if you could get in touch with the police, but you're having enough trouble with them already, aren't you?
Richard Mackenzie, you're pushing for a charge.
That reminds me. Maxine copped one last night. She wants payment and I can't give it to her.
So?
Well, what about you? You should have quite a lot stashed away.
You've got to be kidding. Besides, I told you, all activities are suspended until further notice.
The women aren't going to be too happy about that.
Well, if they feel that strongly about it, they can come and discuss it with me.
Yep, poor old Davo's going to be in trouble with the department over this. At least it makes the freak look bad.
Yeah, Smith sounds like a real smart lady. How early do you reckon she's gone?
I don't know, love. I just hope she's all right. Must have been something pretty bad to make her go over the wall. Oh, excuse me. Oh, it's you.
Any news since last night?
Well, I was hoping you'd tell me that. I mean, really, do you think she's going to turn up here with you guys hanging around all the time?
Hi. What's happening?
Oh, it's Bee's welcoming committee.
Uh-huh. Well, when you go, could you turn your sirens on and burn a bit of rubber? Because half the neighbourhood's out there wondering what's going on. We don't want to disappoint them, do
we? That's right. We don't need that.
All right. We can take a hint. You know where you can contact us if Smith turns up?
Yes, sir.
Will you?
Will I what?
Ring the cops if Bee turns up on your doorstep.
I don't know. I hope I don't have to make that decision.
Well, listen to this. It wouldn't be surprising to learn that there was a room booked at the Hilton for Wentworth escapee Bee Smith, who has been serving a sentence for double murder at the detention centre for the past 13 years. Smith, or Queen Bee, as she is referred to by her fellow inmates, literally walked away from the jail yesterday afternoon and is still at large. Smith not only managed to create a diversion before herself by casting suspicion on another prisoner, but walked out with a change of hair colour and in complete officer's uniform, the uniform of the officer she sent on a wild goose chase.
Well, you are really pleased that Smith caused all this trouble, aren't you?
No, I'm not. But if there had to be an escape and a fall guy because of it, I'm glad it's Joan.
Come on, do you really think we'll get rid of her over this?
I hope so. I'd like to see her try and get around it.
Yes, well, I wouldn't get my hopes up if I were you. She has survived worse. I'll be with the governor if I'm needed.
Bloody paper, will you? Looks as though the dog's been playing with it. I wish I knew what was going on.
Will you stop worrying, Lizzie? Bee can tell us when she gets back.
I only want to know if Bee's all right.
There's nothing much we can do, is there?
Hey, notice anybody else missing this morning? Looks like we scared off the spy.
Yeah, just when we were getting along real well, too.
Good riddance.
Don't worry, it's not the last we're going to hear of her. She'll have plenty to tell the department about us.
Just as long as she says the right things.
Here, sort this lot out.
Did you get my money?
Of course not. I told you she wouldn't pay.
That's not good enough. She's going to have to.
And who's going to get it from her? You? Lizzie, will you come with me, please?
Oh, Mrs. M, have you heard any news of Bee?
No, Lizzie. Been moved to kitchen duty.
Oh, but I thought I was going to work in here this morning.
I'm sorry, we've changed our minds.
Why?
Would you stop asking questions, Lizzie? You have been moved to kitchen duty. Now come along.
Oh.
Well, I have had some clients in my time, but this one was the limit. Well, next he gets on to telling me about his medical problems, which of course leads him to the fact that he and his wife do not do it.
What? What? Oh.
I mean, it was pretty obvious. Oh.
Oh, go on, don't stop because of me.
Yeah, go on.
Oh, well, there's not much more to tell, actually. It's just that despite his age, despite his medical problems, he still said that it was his wife's fault.
Yeah, that'd be right, huh?
Well, I'm here to tell you it wasn't. Oh. Okay, Jude, if it is B, she's not going to want to stay out on that doorstep for too long.
Oh, hi, Trevor.
Sorry, I shouldn't come around uninvited.
Oh, don't be silly. We're happy to have you.
Hello, Miss Matt. Hi, Lindy.
Hi, Trevor. Would you like some coffee?
No, thanks. I just wanted to know if Maxine was coming today.
Oh, sorry, I didn't tell you. The working bee's been called off.
Why?
Well, there was an escape yesterday from Wentworth. They decided to tighten security.
Oh, I saw it on TV.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you if I hear anything new, huh?
Thanks. I better go.
Okay, honey. Bye-bye.
See you later.
Oh, God, he's shy. How's he going to get through life like that?
I don't know. But he's a nice kid, don't you think?
Oh, he's a pain. Would you mind being a bit more specific here? I'm not sure what you really think about that boy. I'll be upstairs if you want me. Getting an old lady like me to clean up after a bunch of screws. It's bloody criminal.
Got a tattoo we haven't seen.
Hey? Nah, it's nonsense newspaper.
Where'd you score that from?
Well, I asked Po-Face to run out and get me one.
Well, what does it say?
Well, it makes women's prison security system look stupid. That's what it says. Listen. She created a diversion for herself by casting suspicion on another prisoner. Hey, that's me. Don't mention any names. Gee, it makes it as plain as day that they reckon the whole thing's the freak's fault.
Beauty.
Good on her.
This should prove very interesting.
I've already seen the papers, Ted.
As if the department's image isn't bad enough. First the women burn the prison down and now this.
If you read it carefully...
There's nothing careful about it. They've made it sound as if we've asked Smith to step out for a couple of days, and they're right.
Yes, they are right, and they have all the facts down perfectly, especially the part about the officer who practically opened the gate for her. I've sent for Miss Ferguson. Perhaps she can tell you about it.
Oh, that's another thing. How did the women know about Gillian Clark?
I don't know. She has her own ideas about that.
Come in. Now, Miss Ferguson, close the door. I want to know what happened yesterday, firsthand.
Yes, sir. I'm afraid the papers are quite right. Smith set a trap for me and I fell for it. I realised that I shouldn't have left my post without first organising for a replacement, but I just didn't stop to think. I was more concerned in locating the contraband. I'm very sorry, sir.
Yes, well, the prisoner has escaped and is still at large. Being sorry isn't going to help.
No, sir.
Mrs. Davidson's going to have to make out a full report on this. It's not going to look very good in your record.
I realise that, sir.
Well, I must say I think it's of great pity. You're copybook material up to now. But this matter can't be overlooked.
No.
Yes. Just a moment, Mrs. Powell. Julian Clark is in reception.
I'll tell them to send her through.
Would you send her to my office, please?
That'll be all, Miss Ferguson.
Will it, sir? I mean, is this the end of the matter?
I shouldn't think so. I'll be discussing it with the board. You'll be informed in due course.
Oh,
I still reckon you should have bought it. It would have looked fabulous.
Listen, will you stop trying to put me in a frock? I need a black lace evening dress like I need a husband.
Don't you knock it until you've tried it.
Just get off my back. Anyway, if I'm going to spend any money, I'm going to spend it sensibly on something like an electric drill or something like that. Oh. And what are you doing inside? It's a nice day out there.
Nothing. I'm bored silly.
Yeah, well, you're going to get even sillier hanging around here.
Oh, yeah, I know, but there's nothing I can do till the girls from Wentworth turn up again. It's all heavy work.
Well, go out and get yourself a suntan.
I suppose I could.
I'd join you, but they're using my bikini as a bedspread.
Oh!
It's just the bottoms.
Shall I stay, Mrs. Davidson?
Yes, of course. There's no reason why you shouldn't hear any of this.
I'm sorry the plan failed, Mr. Douglas. There was no point me staying after the woman found out last night. They wouldn't tell me anything. In fact, from the way they spoke, I think they've known for a couple of days.
Mm. What about the escape? Did they know that was going to happen?
Well, I couldn't say for sure, but I don't think so.
I gather you'll be making a report to the department.
Yes, I'll have it ready in a couple of days. Will that be all right, Mr. Douglas?
Yes, of course.
Tell me, Miss Clark, is there anyone trying to take over as top dog now that B. Smith is gone?
Well, I don't know about that, but it is common knowledge that Nola McKenzie is running things with some sort of insurance scheme that protects the women against punishment.
Oh, so that's what was going on.
But how are they doing all of this without our knowledge? Easy, with the help of an officer.
And do we know who it is, Miss Clark?
Joan Ferguson.
Yes, well, I knew it. We all did.
What proof have you got?
That's just the problem. You won't find a trace of evidence to show her involvement with any of it. Either she's very clever, or the whole thing's a pack of lies.
What the hell do you think you're staring at? Just bugger off.
Sorry. I didn't mean to. I just wanted to give you this. I'm not very good at saying things, so I've written.
Can't I get any privacy around here? You just keep to your side of the fence.
Who the hell fed you all that crap? That spy from the department, I suppose.
It has been reported to me that you, with the help of one of the officers, are running a trading racket. Now, is that true or not?
Trading racket? Oh, hell, she's got a vivid imagination.
Don't be smart, Mackenzie. Answer the question.
I wouldn't know how. I mean, what proof does she have?
The women have been caught with various items they can't buy on the normal buy-up. That can of hair colour, used by Smith, for instance.
We've already told you we know nothing about that escape.
Oh, this is pointless. Get her out of here.
Get outside.
You're not going to leave it at that, are you? Well, she's not going to tell us anything, is she? We can't do anything about it unless we find the contraband or catch her actually trading. Besides, the only thing I'm interested in is proving that Ferguson is involved. And if that means biding my time, then I'm prepared to do it.
Excuse me, Governor. Somehow the women have got hold of some uncensored newspaper. I found this on the recreation room board.
Well, we'd better find out how, hadn't we? I don't expect to be told anything, though.
Right, I'll come with you.
Oh, you've got to hand it to Mrs. Morris, don't you?
Yeah, she's the only one who's ever given two hoots about any of us.
Now, hang on. I didn't say she was the one who left the paper for me. What are you trying to do, get her into trouble?
Oh, come off it, Lizzie. It's pretty obvious, isn't it?
Yeah, I suppose so. It didn't tell us much, did it? We still don't know if B's all right or not.
Yeah. At least it made the freak look bad, though, didn't it?
Yeah. We might get rid of her yet.
I hope so.
All right, pay attention. The governor wants to speak to you.
This clipping was found on the recreation room notice board. I want to know how it got there. I thought as much. Well, there would be no buy-up until I'm given a satisfactory answer.
You bloody idiot. What did you go and do that for? Now we've got no buy-up.
Why are you complaining? You can just rip us off again, can't you?
No way. The freak said no and she meant it.
You're pretty stupid. Do you know that, Maxie?
You leave her alone. Since when have any of you not taken the opportunity to have a go at the freak?
Since it means we all get into trouble, that's when.
Good, Lizzie, what's wrong with them?
I haven't got a top dog to keep them together anymore. You just watch them. They'll be at each other's throats in next to no time.
Oh. Hey, I just thought of something.
Here we go.
Well, if we've all lost buy-up, we can all claim, right?
Yeah.
God, you've got a short memory. I haven't got a cent and the freak won't pay, remember?
Like I said, she'll have to. And if we all stick together, we can make her.
How?
Ah, I don't know. Can't think of something straight off, but I will.
Oh, sure. And it'll be just like every other time. She'll come out on top and we'll probably get a thumping for trying it on.
You lot are a mob of panic merchants. I told you we should leave things as they are now. We'll be back in business as soon as things have cooled down.
Meanwhile, we are losing money, not to mention buy-up and remissions and God knows what else till then. B wouldn't stand for it, and I don't reckon we should either.
No. I'll be in on that. What about you lot?
Yeah.
Yeah, see, that's why I decided to paint the place lighter colours. You know, these old places can look really dingy if you choose that.
Hey, you didn't stay outside long.
I was only out there for 1 minute before that perv from next door was hanging over the fence.
Oh, come on, Lindy. He's only trying to make friends.
Oh, fool, I saw the way he was looking at me.
Oh, then come and help us pick a colour for upstairs.
No. Oh, look, that creep's upset me. I'm going to get a drink or something.
Oh, just a minute. I don't like the or something.
Stop worrying, will you? I said I'm going to get a drink, that's all.
Can you honestly look me in the face and tell me you're not going to see your pusher? Oh.
Who are you scoring from?
I don't know yet, but I know where to go. Well, I've got to have something. I'll go mad. I can't stop shaking.
All right.
Helen!
Oh, Judy, she's going to do it whether we like it or not. We can't lock her up.
Oh, God.
I don't want you to go to any of your old haunts. You go to a friend of mine instead. There'll be no questions asked and no problems if you tell him that I sent you, okay?
Okay. Thanks, Helen.
Well, I don't like it one bit.
Well, I reckon it's a great idea, Lizzie.
Yeah. Well, what about the rest of you? Are you with us or not?
There's no point. You know you can't beat her, and you're only burning your bridges. Let all the fuss die down, and we'll start getting our goodies back in no time.
She's got a point there, Lizzie.
Like hell she has. She's only trying to save her own bloody neck.
Well, I don't know if it's worth all the trouble.
God, now I know how Bee must have felt. Look, the only way we can beat the freak is by sticking together. And if we all follow the plan, we can't lose. I'll do all the talking. Now, who's going to be in it? Well, let's go.
Who wants him?
I'm Lindy. Helen Smart said you could help me out.
Oh, old Helen. Yeah, we might be able to do business.
They're all very quiet this afternoon. Probably worried about Smith. I doubt it. I think it's forgotten who she is by now. Oh, what's happening now?
Knew that silence was too good to be true.
Yeah.
Miss Ferguson, Mrs. Davidson took away all our buyer privileges, Osavo. You remember? You were there. We want a claim.
What are you talking about?
It's quite simple, Mrs. Powell. Miss Ferguson's got us all insured against punishment like that. And she owes us all $5 each.
Yes, she does too.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun to when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare. Right.